Dinner was to be served at my home. I went to pick him up at the motel. I told him it was one time, and he told him he called the house, and they told him it was a different time. So that gave us an hour to finish getting ready. So you gotta get ready. So three of us, three preachers in a room, Abernathy, King, and Kyles, the last three. And so what did three preachers do in a room for an hour? Said, we talk preacher talk. He said, what do you mean you talk preacher? I said, just like barbers talk, barber talk. And we were having fun. Just good, clean, wholesome fun. Martin and I walked on the porch. Abernathy was still in the room. And he said, come on, Ralph. You're going to make us late. Some bitty talk like that. So you're going to make us late. I said, well, it's not our intention to make you late. I just want to be looking right, because there might be some pretty ladies over there, and I want to be looking right. Jesse Jackson was walking on the lower part, and he said, Jesse, don't bring that whole band to Kyle's house. He said, I'm not going to bring the band. He said, well, don't bring him. It's too many. He said, but my musician wants to meet you. You brought the music. He said, okay. Jesse Jackson leaned over on the railing of the balcony. Ralph was still in the room. Jesse was leaning over. I said, guys, come on, let's go. By that time, the shot rang out. Kapow! Martin was here and I was here. The bullet knocked him to the ground, to the floor. I turned and saw him fall. And oh my goodness, chaos. What can I do? Well, why was I there? Of all the places I could have been, all the places he could have been, why was I there at that moment in time? And over the years, God revealed to me why I was there. Martin didn't die in some foolish, untoward way. He didn't overdose. He wasn't shot leaving the scene of a crime. He was a man with PhD at 27, Nobel Peace Prize at 34, all the things he could have been. And here he is, as we speak. Here he is, lying bloody on the cold sidewalk of a motel in Memphis, Tennessee. And they said, we will shoot this dreamer and see what happens to his dream. Yes, I must admit it, I must be honest. You can kill the dreamer, but no, you cannot kill the dream.